Hey guys, this is Amlash Sharma and today I would be discussing about the SQL joins. What is the SQL join and why do we need the SQL join? Basically, SQL joins is used to merge the output from the two or multiple tables. Sometimes we need to merge the output from the two or multiple tables, then we can use the joins. In the examples, you can see we are using the three tables, table A, table B and table C. So it means we are merging these tables and we are merging the output of the tables and we are like creating the new output. And the new output we get would be the like basis of the type of join we use. It means to use the join, we need at least two or more tables. Now, we come to the types of the joins. You can see there are six types of joins: inner join, left join, right join, full join, self join, and cross joins. So all these six types of joins we would be discussing in details one by one. Before we discuss all these joins, let us create some tables on the SQL server. So you can see we have created the two tables, the employee and the employee details. In employee table we have the master data, and in employee details table we have the related information of the employee tables. And there is a common key, common column, that is the EMP ID. We would be using this column for joining the these two tables. Okay, now back to the content. Okay, so in this like joins, we would be using the terms the left and table and again. So what is the left table and the right table? If you can see in this example, we are using a query that is a select ID MP address from employee. It means when we use the table name in the select statement, that is the left table, and the other table which we are joining, the employee table, is called the right table. Okay. Let us start with the very first join, that is the SQL Server inner join. Inner join produces a data set that includes row from the left table which have matching rows from the right table. What does it mean? In this diagram, you can see we have two tables. In the left side, we have the employee table. On the right side, we have the employee details tables. And there is a common area. Common area indicates that we are joining these two tables on the basis of the EMP ID, because EMP ID is a common in both table. So let us understand with this another diagram. So we have a query that is the select star from employee, and we are using the inner join. So in the left side you can see in the employee table, and the right side you can see the employee details tables. The green arrow shows that EMP ID of the employee table also exists in the employee details table, and the red shows that the ID does not exist in the employee detail tables. So which ID also exists in the employee detail tables will be included in the result, and the ID which does not exist in the employee detail tables will not be included. So you can see in the result that employee ID number 5 does not exist in the output, because for the employee ID 5 there is no matching ID in the employee details table, in the right table. Okay, let us try this query on the SQL server. Just copy and paste this query. And now you can see the result. In the results you can see the EMP ID number 5 does not exist, because that 5 does not match in the employee details table. Okay, so next is the SQL left join. SQL left join, it returns all the rows from the left table if there are no matches in the right table. What does it mean? It means it will take all the records from the left table, and if there is no match in the right table, then it will display the null value for the right table columns. So you can see the diagram. Again, we have the both table, the employee and employee details. In the left side, employee table, and the right side, in the employee detail tables. So it will take all the left circle is the filled one. It means it will take all the records from the left table. So let us understand with this another diagram. So you can see again, if you like, we are using the left join in this query. So again, you can see the from EMP ID from 1 to 4 again is a matching one, but the fifth one is not matching one. It means if you use the left join, so it will take all the five records, but for the fifth record, it will display the null value for the right table columns, as you can see in the results. Okay, let us try this query on the SQL Server. Okay, so you can see in the result, for the fifth record, name is shown, but for the employee age, employee address, and the employee salary, there are null value because it's a unmatched record. Okay, next is the right join, SQL right join. SQL right join, it returns rows from the right table even if there's no match in the left table. Again, it's a opposite of the left join. For the unmatched value in the left table, null value is displayed in the output. Again, you can see in the diagram. The right one is the filled one. It means the right table, all rows will be included in the results. So let us again understand with the another example. So in this query, we are using the right join. Again, you can see in the employee details tables, there are four rows matching in the employee table. And the employee ID 8 and 10, there is no match in the employee table. It means in the output, there would be a null value for the employee details, employee table columns. Like this. Okay, let us try this query on the SQL Server. So you can see the last two records means the employee ID 8 and 10. There is no matching in the employee table. So there would be a null value for the employee table columns, the EMP ID and the employee name. Okay, next is the SQL Full Join. SQL Full Joins returns rows where there is a match in one of the tables. And in fact, it is a combination of the left and join and the right join. In this diagram, you can see in the left side, we have the employee name. Again, the right side, we have the employee detail tables and there is a common area. Even like you can see there is a formula. Formula is in full join equal to left rows from the left join plus rows from the right join, then minus duplicate rows. So we can understand this another diagram. So in this query, we are using the full join, and you can see in the employee table, employee ID does not match with the employee details tables, and in employee details table, employee ID 8 and 10 does not match in the employee table. So all the records from the employee table and all the records from the employee details table will be taken, and then it will subtract the duplicate records from both table, and the null value will be displayed from both column for the unmatched rows. You can see in this one. The EMP ID number 5th does not exist in the employee detail table. That's why we have the null for the employee age, employee address, and the employee salary. And the EMP ID 8 and 10 in employee detail tables does not match in the employee table. That's why we have the null value for the employee ID and employee name. Let us try this query on the SQL Server. You can see in the result, for the EMP ID 5th, there is a null value. for the EMPS address and salary, and the EMP ID for the 8 and 10, which is coming from the employee details tables, have the null value for the employee table. Okay, so next one is the cross join. The SQL cross join produces a result set which is the number of rows in the first table multiplied by the number of rows in the second table, and this is also called the Cartesian product. In the cross join, we do not have the relationship between the joined tables. So to understand this cross join, we have a formula. You can check this one. The cross join equal to total number of rows in the table 1 multiplied by the total number of rows in the table 2. So we can check the another diagram. In this SQL query, we are using the cross join without any relationship. So in employee table, we have the 5th records, and the employee details tables, we have the 6th records. It means the first records will be multiplied by the 6th first time, the second record will be multiplied by the again number of 6, the third record will be multiplied by the 6. So the result would be the 5 multiplied by 6 means 30 records. So if we try this query on the SQL server, so you can check for the EMP ID, there are the 6 records, this one, because there are 6 records in the employee tables. Again, for the second record, which is the Suresh, and the EMP ID is the Suresh, again are the 6 records, which is coming from the employee details tables. So total number of records are the 30. Okay, so next one is the self-join. Self-join is join which a table is joined with itself. It means we have only one table in the self-join. When the primary key and the foreign key exist on the same table, then we can use the self-join. When you use the self-join, a virtual copy is created from the original table. In that case, you have the two tables and you can use the self-join. To understand this self-join, let us create some table and data. You can see we have created table that the company. In company, we have the EMP ID, EMP name, manager ID, and city. Suppose we have to find out the employee name and his manager. In this example, you can see the employee ID is the 1, then employee name is the Anil, and his manager ID is 6. So we have to find out the manager of the Anil. Okay, back to content. So to understand this one, we have this diagram. When you use this query, you can see in the from, we are using the company A, company B. Company A means A, it's an alias, and again B is the alias. When you use this one, it means the SQL server is creating the virtual copy for the company original table. And internally, so it has two tables and it is joining the both table. You can see the for the EMP ID 1, Anil, his manager ID 6. In the virtual copy on the 6th number, we have the Kumar. It means Kumar is the manager of the Anil. Again, for the Sunil, manager ID 2, and then the another table on the EMP ID is that Sunil. It means the Sunil is the manager of the Sunil. For the Mahesh, manager ID is 4, and on the right table, on the 4th EMP ID, the Suresh is the employee. It means Suresh is the manager of the Mahesh. So you can see in the output, you can see the employee ID, employee name, manager ID, and manager name. Thank you so much.